Good morning, friends. Let me thank FICCI, the World Bank, and all our stakeholders and partners for organizing the event with us to address a real common concern of all Indians, and obviously not just Indians, but those who do business with India, the friends of India, who I can see in large numbers. And therefore, this is something which we need to address very quickly, is an issue related to logistics. In fact, for long, we have identified two or three reasons why India's true potential is not realized fully. One was, this has been going on for a few decades, one was the cost of power. And therefore, we had introduced the Electricity Act, which then created competition, added capacity, and then brought down cost as well. Of course, there needs to be more measures in terms of reducing transmission distribution losses, which can bring down it further. And as we go on for innovation by creating new technologies, the power cost can come down at generation level itself in a significant way. The second is logistic. After power, the cost of power is something which inhibits the industrial growth. Second, the cost of logistics, the time it takes to reach out from one place to another is then. And obviously, third one is the interest which we, the monetary issue, which is related to macroeconomic issue. But two of the things that were something which could be addressed very quickly, and one of them was power. The second one is logistics. And in logistics, we have large number of players who actually play a key role into logistic. There are many ministries which deal with logistic. There are many departments of the government of India as well as state government deal with logistic. And therefore, one of the big challenges of logistic was that having identified as a problem, there are no single nodal agency which could deal with that. And I'm really thankful to Honorable Prime Minister for having identified this as a key action point and has appointed and created a new division within the Ministry of Commerce. It's the first time that logistic as a subject we dealt with at the level of Government of India, and therefore that is going to be dealt with the Ministry, and therefore we are all here to address this issue. As I said, the entrepreneurship of India, which is there in abundance, which has proven capabilities as is displayed at all levels, and in different countries, were the key element which can actually allow it to blossom further is dealing with the logistic issue. We have ports because we have such a large coastline. We have railways, which is one of the largest networks in the world. We have ports, roads. We have airports, which is again now increasing rapidly, because we had only about less than 70 in the 70 years of independence, and we'll be creating new 56 airports in the next few years' time. And that would mean that you can imagine the connectivity that will improve considerably. Even the railways, what we did in the first 70 years of 3,75,000 crores of investment, say 4 lakh crores of investment into capex, in the first 3 years itself, the commitment of Government of India is to add 3,75,000 crores to capex of India. So, railways are putting in more money, roads are getting increase, then the definition, the division between minor ports and major ports, because minor ports were dealt with by the state governments, major ports were dealt by the central government, but minor never became major, though in real life you can become minor, can become major, but it could not happen. So that again is an issue which is addressed at a level of the Government of India, and we are trying to develop all ports with all potential, whether they are small, minor, major, whatever. And therefore, there is an exponential investment that is going on in the infrastructure. Our idea is that we must put at least 10% of the GDP into infrastructure, and that we need to do year after year for many more years to come. But while we are on track to do that, even if we create individual segment of infrastructure growth at much rapid pace and it increases its capacity tremendously, still there is a challenge how to bring these different modes of transportation, different modes of communication into one single actionable point. Therefore, this multimodal transport is something which is really called for and necessary. Some can move from railways, but from the point of head from railways, how can it be connected to road? Even if you develop ports and you don't have a hinterland connectivity, how will that happen? Even if you airlift a cargo from one place but cannot be connected by road from that airport, how will this going to happen? So there are many challenges which are related to this, which now logistic division department, as which is in the Ministry of Commerce, will be able to address and try to bring in different forms of it. So my colleagues will explain to you in detail. I have to go to the parliament. And therefore, I just prefer to speak before others. One area that we are targeting is how to digitalize these entire processes. How to make sure that with the existing infrastructure, how can you optimize its use to bring in the best efficiencies? Because one is augmentation, which is happening and which is going to take time because everything has a time frame in which it can be created. But while we create new infrastructure and that new infrastructure also get into some sort of a synergy with the overall plan of logistic, how do you use the present infrastructure available in India today and try to connect it by logistic? And therefore, this is a very important key area that can happen to digitalization process, for which we are actually trying to gain experiences of countries like UAE, Singapore, and many others who have got already gained experience in terms of how they manage it very efficiently. While we do all this, the end result, we should be clear about why we are doing it. For example, the Commerce Ministry has recently come out with a policy for agriculture exports. Now, that is one area in which there can be huge possibilities of exporting different kinds of products, and also quantity can be very large. But unless we have a support of air support to make that it can happen, how are you going to agriculture products and many like fruits and vegetables or milk products, they have some shelf life. They cannot last for long. They are perishable. Therefore, time is of essence to export them. But unless we have a air connectivity where we can evacuate it very fast, how is it going to happen? So therefore, bringing different ministries and different action points together is very important. Luckily, Prime Minister has asked me to also look at aviation. So now we are also finding out, creating aviation support to make sure that its agriculture export will happen in a rapid way. So same thing we'll do with other ministries and colleague ministries, and we'll try to work on that. So the whole idea is that making sure, bring the synergies in a way that we can immensely benefit from the potential that India has. And we are already seeing that India is emerging as a big market, already $2.5 trillion of economy, which is poised to be $5 trillion in the next few years' time. If we can bring in the logistic support to it, you can imagine the benefit that will accrue to it. Many times people keep complaining that it is the time that it takes to ship a product from Indian shore to abroad takes less time, less time than the time it takes from with shipping within the country. So I think we are really aware of these issues. We have started working on those issues, and I'm sure this type of a partnership will really help us a great deal, because this is essentially an issue of many stakeholders coming together and working together. And therefore, this is a very good idea of having this summit. And therefore, I once again congratulate all the organizers for making it happen. I can assure you one thing, that whatever is the deliberation that is going to happen, whatever new ideas will emanate from it, there are my colleagues who are sitting here who will make sure that we take them to the logical conclusion and implement them. So we really look forward to your active participation, and also look forward to not just participation for today's meeting, but this long journey that we have to travel together to ensure that India's logistic improves considerably. In fact, there's a logistic index which now we are developing, and we are trying to do it for every state, and every state is supposed to now compete with each other to make it happen. So I think there are many measures we already taken which will be explained to you, but the idea is to ensure that logistic becomes a key thrust area for our government to work on, and in which society will benefit, our business community will develop it, our international trade will rise, and also new investment will come into this sector. So thank you very much. Congratulations.